I'm Nick Leister from the SolidWorks training team. SolidWorks offers several selection tools, ideal for large or complicated models. In this video, I'll show you how to hide parts quickly within an assembly, activate selection filters, use the Select Other command, toggle between Box and Lasso Selection, define and modify selection sets, apply transparency, use the Magnify Selection tool, and use Select Tangency to select multiple faces and edges automatically. Let's get started. I have an electronics enclosure that I'm preparing for analysis in SolidWorks Flow. I will add a plane and create selection sets for the analysis, but the outer parts obscure the inner geometry I need to reference. Hiding components that get in the way will make selections easier. I'll select one of the outer parts and click Hide Components. Unfortunately, this is a slow process. A faster method is to hover over the part with the cursor and use the keyboard's Tab key. You can also show a hidden part by holding Shift and clicking Tab. Now, I'll access the selection filter by clicking F5 on the keyboard, which I'll explore as I define a plane. The plane will reference the bottom of the heatsink, but the face is challenging to access. Therefore, I'll right-click over the heatsink and click Select Other, which allows me to select through the geometry. There's too much geometry to choose from. I'll use the selection filter to filter out everything but faces. Now, I only see faces, and selecting the geometry is more manageable. I'll complete the plane's definition. I want to isolate the heat pipes and heat sink, so I'll select them and hide all the other parts within the assembly. Unfortunately, the default box selection tool grabs too many components, so I'll right-click and choose Lasso Selection. Now, I'll click Invert Selection from the selection filter bar, right-click, and select Hide Components. The keyboard's Control key allows me to select multiple faces at once. Now, I'll define a selection set. A selection set stores predefined selections for quick access later. To create a new selection set, I'll right-click, expand Save Selection, and choose New Selection Set. A folder at the top of the tree stores my selection sets. I'll add more selections to this newly created selection set, but this geometry is behind the heat sink. Applying transparency is an excellent method for selecting through existing geometry. I'll add these selections to the thermal glue selection set. To do this, I'll right-click, expand Save Selections, and click Thermal Glue. I can quickly show all this assembly's parts from the top of the tree and hide the cover and bezel parts. Parts can contain selection sets too. This CPU part contains a selection set. If I activate the parts selection set, I can easily add its selections to the assembly's selection set. Now, I'll build up the existing adiabatic walls selection set, but the entities I want to add are quite small. The G key toggles the Magnify Selection tool on and off, allowing me to zoom in and out while scrolling the middle mouse button. Here, the remaining faces around the outside are tangent to one another. So, while holding the Control key to keep the initial selection, I'll right-click one of the faces and click Select Tangency, which selects all the remaining faces. Now, I'll add the selections to the adiabatic wall selection set. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this content helpful, visit the site below to access a playlist highlighting SolidWorks' selection tools.